have around the house. I have two blocks, a blanket. If you have a strap, that's also great. A bolster or even a pillow from your bed will work. So we'll begin in a restorative child's pose. Take your blanket, whoever it is, right? Fold it. I'm just going to make a small lift for behind the ankles. Okay, so coming into child's pose. Placing our feet on the blanket. Take the knees wide. So the blanket is supporting your ankles. Bring the bolster or your pillow in between your legs and go ahead and lay all the way down. Turn your head to one side and close your eyes. And begin to settle in, letting all worry and to-do lists begin to melt away. Staying just as you are. Content with everything you have. With the eyes closed, really mindfully turn your head to the other side of the bolster. Settle back into the pose, maybe taking a big breath in, exhale and melt back in. Another moment or two here to soften. And with your eyes closed, really mindfully remove the bolster. Lay back down into your child's pose. Keep the elbows bent, maybe even as wide as the mat. I like to rest my head on my palms and just take a moment to notice the difference, how much softer in the heart, heavy in the chest. You press your forehead into your palms and release all of the tension in the neck. Let's take three Bring your arms alongside the body. Turn your head to one side. Let the shoulders just naturally slouch towards your ears. The hips may do a slight rock here. Just noticing low back. With an opportunity to pay attention to our entire body. To take good care of our whole being. Take a big breath in, breathe into your low back, open your mouth, press your air out. Turn your head to the other side. Take a moment, let the natural shape come in. Take another deep breath in here. Exhale and deflate. And then really slowly press yourself up. And we'll move into a supported bridge pose. So grab your strap if you have one. You can place it around your thighs. I don't have my strap right now. So the strap will go just above the knees to keep the thighs held in. We're going to lay all the way down. Make sure that there is not anything underneath the neck here. It's important to keep the natural curve in the neck. So grab a block. Okay? On your inhale, breathe in and lift your hips up. Take the block, maybe even to the lowest height, even though you know you can put it to the highest height. Try to be extra kind to yourself today and your body especially. So I'm going to put my block at the lowest height, okay? Get into that sweet spot, and then arms alongside the body, palms face up, close your eyes, take a deep breath in, exhale, and settle in. Chin draws slightly away from the chest, putting pressure in the back of the head and opening up the throat chakra as well as your heart. And bringing your attention back to the natural breath. Witness without judgment or expectation, just to observe the breath as it is in its natural state. Your mind may begin to wander. Bring your attention back to the breath, maybe taking another deep breath in to draw you back in. Tuning in to the body. Eyes are closed, eyes stay closed. what you are doing in this moment, in this shape, in this space. Before we move on, let's take 5 full breaths here. Breathe in. Breathe out. Again, bigger breath in. Longer breath out. Two more. Breathe in and out. One more, breathe in through the nose, open your mouth, let it out. Slowly press into your feet, lift your butt up, remove the block and lower back down, nice and slow. I like to hold the block on my belly, heel toe your feet as wide as the mat, let the knees collapse in towards each other. Take a moment here, letting everything. Noticing any different sensations in the body. And then inhale and hug both knees in towards the chest. Bring the arms alongside the body. Just draw a circle on the ceiling with the knees together. Massaging. And then exhale, roll to one side. Eyes stay closed, rest your head on your bicep. Curl the knees close to the chest. Take a moment here, take a really big breath in on your side. Exhale and melt into the floor. Do that again, breathe in. Exhale, melt. Use the hand in front of you, the one you're not lying on. Press it into the floor. We'll take a seated forward fold, Paschimottanasana next. So come to sit, right? And you can take your legs out wide or you can keep them close together. It doesn't matter, right? Grab your pillow or your bolster. Okay. I like to take mine here, maybe flip it this direction, okay? And build yourself a platform here, right? Make your little block wedges, okay? There's no science to this. Just kind of got to figure out what works, okay? And then, if you have low back pain or sciatica, you can prop the blanket up underneath your butt. You can also take the blanket and put it underneath your knees, right? So really try to utilize your props here. So props are often viewed as a sign of weakness, but they are offering a sign of support, right? It's supportive to your practice to use these props, right? So then find your setup, and then come to stillness. As you fold, just ever so slightly, really gentle fold over the legs. Right? So no need to flex the toes here. Maybe even wiggle the toes and let them relax. Right? Commit to a position and find stillness. Again, you may take a big breath in to pull you in. To relax you into the pose, to be in this shape, in this moment. Continuing to come back to the natural breath, noticing this rhythm that already flows throughout you. This practice of restorative yin is an opportunity to let go, an opportunity to notice all the things that you push aside. Sink into stillness and to be content in that stillness. Not wanting anything more or less. Turn your head to the other side if your head is turned. Keep your eyes closed, move slow, move with meaning. Attention to the breath. Staying present, conscious. Knowing that this practice, restorative yin, you deserve this time. You deserve to give this energy, to give away to everyone else without even blinking an eye. You deserve to give it back to yourself. slowly begin to peel yourself up. Remove your ulcer. And we'll come into Supta Baddha Konasana. I'm all out of it. Okay, so if you have a strap, that would be amazing. Make a big loop, put it around you. Right? If you've done that with me before, you know what I'm talking about. If not, ask me and I'll let you know. I don't have a strap to demo right now, but okay, so take your bolster or your blanket, your bolster or your pillow, and your blanket, give yourself a little pillow. Okay, long ways. Set up this key. Okay, take that back behind your butt. Okay, about an inch or two away from your butt. Bring your feet together and your knees wide for Supta Baddha Konasana. I like to take a block underneath each thigh or knee. So it's not quite the knee because my knees don't touch, it's more the thigh. Okay, so kind of finding that good sweet spot. And then we'll lay all the way back. Okay, ooh, bring your arms up alongside you. Palms face up. Close your eyes and let yourself melt into this pose. Feel the soles of the feet connected. The blanket is just above the shoulders, supporting the head. You may take a full breath in to invite yourself into this shape. Relax the jaw, pressing the tongue to the roof of the mouth. Maybe even parting the lips slightly. Fix your gaze on the space in between your eyebrows. Let all outside distractions slip away. If you have extra blankets, you would put them underneath your forearms. So one underneath each arm, or even another pillow, or maybe two blocks. So you would need another four blocks. If you're already really zoned out in this shape, just stay. But if you're still kind of finding your comfort here, maybe add a proper two, maybe take one away. Really setting yourself up so you can be at ease. And feel this sense of peace, this energy that you are cultivating within you that you'll send out to the rest of the world. Beyond the world, the universe. Sending all of that energy beyond the space. breath in. And out. Three more. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two. One more breath on your side, breathe in and out. Slowly press yourself up, coming to a tall spine. Close your eyes when you get there. Maybe grab your blanket and you come to sit on your blanket. Come to sit in Sukhasana, easy pose. I like to always put my non-dominant foot forward again, non-ego. Non-ego forward. So close your eyes, just find a tall spine. Let's just pause here for a moment. Notice the difference and how much better you feel when you take time for yourself. Bring your palms together to center in prayer. We'll seal our practice and our intention to come together with the sound of one all. Exhale out all of your air. Breathe in and sit tall. Namaste. Thank you guys so much.